Thanks so much for joining us, and today we're going to visit Conway High School and learn about a very involved health science class where students are doctors and our teachers are their patients. Plus, we'll visit Early College High School and check out why they have a lot to celebrate right now as we take you inside Horry County Schools.
You have some numbness in your arms. How are you feeling today? What could be your...
This is the health science class at Conway High School. Each student doctor had a teacher patient and had to diagnose them and come up with a health plan.
Oh, I had four different diagnoses before I found out what he had. I went to a website and I typed in his symptoms and it came up Hashimoto's disease, and that's what he had. We did like blood pressure, temperature, height, weight, and we did some like meal plans and nutrition plans.
Well, his chest pain, he was just like, it's extreme. Like, it's awful. And I was like, okay. So when I did some research, he was also telling me he knew it wasn't lung related. So as the episode continued, they diagnosed him with Marfan's. And so I did my research. I was like,
The interesting thing is that Kenley's patient, Mr. Lynch, is actually diagnosed with this.
I gave her the symptoms, fully expecting she would never figure this out because it's very rare.
Really?
Okay. 24 hours, she comes back and she goes, you have Marfan syndrome. Which I went...
Were you surprised she figured it out that fast?
Darn it.
You were trying to stump her.
Yes.
Well, what aren't they learning? They're learning how to interact with people. They're learning about healthcare. They're learning to research. They're learning to formulate a plan. They're learning patience. And I mean P-A-T-I-E-N-C-E. Patients, because they want instant answer, they want instant gratification. That's not how this works.
And Westerbeck did a great job of asking a bunch of questions back and forth to eliminate small things too. I wasn't giving him the best information, but he did a really good job communicating with me and just bouncing ideas off me and was able to kind of pick apart one at a time. I mean, it just takes it and it makes it relevant to him. It sets him up for on-the-job training that they'll be able to have. Ms. Watson does a great job lining these guys up, and they're able to just step right in and do stuff out in the real world.
The project is so real that Mr. Lynch had his student doctor, Kenley, watch him very closely.
For the first day, my blood pressure was 135 over 105.
And
that's very abnormal for me. So we did some research and found out if I stayed on a certain diet, that it would be greatly reduced. So my nurse here has been on my case every day. They even got mad at me for eating ice cream at our Honor Society dinner.
I caught him. I caught him eating it, and I said, Mr. Lynch, what are you doing? And he was like, you don't see me. I was like,
yes, I do.
Yeah, I do.
And health science teacher Lucia Watson has a lot of support from Conway's community.
This is a brand new program here at Conway High School. So when I got all of the equipment that was not here before, they were all, oh, what's in that box? Let's open it up. Let's take a look at it. How does it work? Show it to me. Can we use it? So they really were into that part of it. Thank you. Yes, I want to talk about Conway Medical Center.
All right, let's do that.
Because they have been a wonderful partner to us. They donated the bed.
Ah.
You know, several boxes of gloves and gowns, and they donated all of that.
And by donating tools and donating resources and having folks go out there, Lucia is so open to having us come out and speak. And so when these children are engaged with these tools, learning about these career opportunities, not only are they engaged in healthcare, but we're helping to build confidence in them and build skills so that by the time they're able to make some choices about their college or about their futures, they're a little more educated.
Lucia's health science class also includes the administrative side of a career in healthcare.
How it works, the deductible, the copayment, coinsurance, maximum, the premium? I mean, are you somebody who needs to have a higher deductible plan because you're younger and healthier, or do you need a lower deductible plan because you're somebody who's really going to use those doctor visits?
I want to be a nurse, actually. So this was right. This was, I loved it.
No, it was awesome. It kind of made me want to be in the health care anymore.
Somebody's going to find a cure for cancer one day. Somebody's going to cure Alzheimer's one day. Who's to say that person's not going to be in South Carolina or in Horry County or from a Conway High School STEM program?
This year, Lucia Watson has actually started a pharmacy tech program, and we'll visit her again to check that out. And now, a huge congratulations to Early College High School, named a National Blue Ribbon School. Congratulations to Horry County Schools Early College High School, this year a National Blue Ribbon School. But beyond the excitement and national recognition, these students understand that this is what you get from hard work and dedication.
We do respect one another, and respect is what we base our schooling on here.
Everyone's so dedicated, the faculty and staff, everyone's here for each other, and we have a great sense of family here.
We're all really close-knit here. It's like a little family, and it's just really awesome.
Early College High School students also have the chance to earn an associate's degree from Horry Georgetown Technical College.
When you get 58% of your students graduating with an Associate of Arts, what do you want next? You want 60%, you want 64%. So you just have to keep pushing. And I don't think the National Blue Ribbon is something where you stop. I think that's just something where you go, wow, somebody recognizes what we're doing. We always want to keep moving. And keep reaching everybody in the district.
Because we do feel like family. We are close-knit. We have advisory, which becomes our little miniature family. We meet together on Fridays, but then our classes are smaller in size, and we just have special relationships that way. We're able to form special relationships with our students and our parents. So it's coming to your second family every day.
I'll graduate with my associate's degree from tech in the arts, actually before I graduate with my high school diploma.
You know, we're going into this new world of taking all these college classes and stuff like that, but it's excitement now. Before it was just scared, like, oh, I don't know if I'll make new friends or anything like that, and now it's excitement for what's to come.
So a big congratulations to our Early College High School, again named one of this year's National Blue Ribbon Schools. And thank you so much for taking time to learn a little bit more about your school district. Please become our friend on Facebook, check out our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter, and of course, watch us right here on HCS TV 12. Come again next time I take you inside Horry County Schools.